Hi there, my name is Carlos, and I'm a graduate student at Harvard University, where I study a very cool and interesting ability that some animals, like this one right here, can do. But before I tell you all about it, let me ask you one question. What do you think would happen to this animal if it suffers such a big injury that it gets split in two parts of the same animal? Well, let's put it to test right now. Ah! Now we have two parts, two fragments of the same animal. But don't worry, because over time, this animal is able to regrow all of the parts that it lost due to this injury. When an injury like this happens, the head fragment will regrow a very pointy tail, and the tail fragment will regrow a whole new head. The ability to regrow a specific part or tissue of an animal's body when it's lost is called regeneration. And this has intrigued scientists for many, many years. How is it that some animals can regenerate such big parts of their bodies when injuries like that happen? Well, let me tell you something. Humans can also regenerate very specific tissues in our bodies. And an example of this is our skin. We've all been here. Sometimes we're working with a sheet of paper, and we know that if this is at the perfect angle, it can cause some paper cuts in our skin. But we also know that over time, these paper cuts in our skin will heal, and sometimes we don't even notice we ever had a paper cut there. And although the skin is a good example of tissues that regenerate in our bodies, we cannot grow a whole new limb if we lose one. So how is it that some animals can overcome this limitation? Well, in order to understand this, let's go back to our main protagonist in this video. Meet Hostenia miamia, a marine invertebrate species commonly known as the three-banded panther worm. This animal is very small. You wouldn't be able to get all of these details without a microscope. The three-banded part of the name comes from the three cream color stripes in its body, which is different in all of the individuals. And panther comes from these animals being a predator to other smaller animals that also live in their natural habitat. Over a decade ago, these animals were collected from the Walsingham Pond in Bermuda Islands, where they live among mangrove roots, and they were brought all the way back to the United States for scientists to uncover the secrets that lie within this animal's ability to regenerate. The kind of regeneration that Hofstenia undergoes is known as whole body regeneration, resulting in a complete and functional animal. Hofstenia has different types of tissues. It has muscle that is spread around the whole body plan, many neurons in the brain, which is found in the head, a plentiful gut that helps it digest all the small animals that it eats, an epidermis that protects it from the outside world. And because Hofstenia is able to do whole body regeneration, it is able to regenerate all of these parts no matter where the injury happens. So, how exactly does Hofstenia achieve this regeneration? During whole body regeneration, a white tissue known as a blastema appears along the wound site, both in the head and the tail fragment. If we focus only on the tail fragment, a few days after the injury, the blastema contains a special kind of cell with important properties called neoblasts. These cells are known as stem cells, and these are the ones in charge of producing the cells that are lost. As regeneration happens, certain genes will turn on in these neoblasts. Based on many experiments that we have done in our lab, we hypothesize that these genes give neoblasts the instructions to become the future cell types that will form the new specific tissues. For example, this neoblast in magenta is expressing genes that are neurons. And because of this, we hypothesize that it will become a neuron. This way, new tissue will be formed in each individual Hofstenia, surviving the injury and going about their daily marine tasks. And although this sounds like a very solid story, the research does not end there.
There are so many questions to be answered. I study regeneration in Hofstenia because there are very few studies of this type of regeneration in Hofstenia done so far. And this type of research is very important because we're learning about regeneration abilities that so many different animals have, including Hofstenia. So if you have any questions about regeneration, type of regeneration that happens in different animals, and how much I love being a scientist, make sure to take notes so you can ask me later. Bye.